welcome to my first Let's Playthrough. This is Transformers Universe Online, a new game coming out. Welcome. This game is actually in closed beta right now.
Alongside you is an honor for all Autobots. Select the first of many Autobot warriors to join your battle group. Your recruit will meet you on the outskirts of High Grand.
As you can see, you start off with a bulkhead type character named Monsoon. You get the basic three weapons to start off with: an Energon Axe, Gatling Gun, and some other laser pistol. You eventually get to the command center after a small tutorial showing you how to fire your weapons and take out enemies. As you can see, it's similar to the base in Transformers Prime, where Ratchet is still on Earth, supposedly, and leading the Autobots against Viacons, who are still on the planet. You can choose an Autobot side or Decepticon side at the start of the game.
Visit the hangar, and I'll explain how to use them to recruit another Autobot warrior.
There wasn't really anybody online at the time. The servers are pretty empty unless they have some type of scheduled thing on the weekend. Right now they are doing some live feeds on some other channels, so there might be some people on today to play with. I couldn't get into the multiplayer mode. There was really nobody else on at the same time. So I'm just looking around the base. There's not much in the base right now. I'm guessing since it's still in beta, there's probably going to be some other things later. It's probably going to be pretty busy in here with other players walking around. I don't know what that is. You know I can't read Spanish. And the green lights that come up, those are the waypoints. You'll have missions, you'll have objectives when you start off. You're going into this waypoint now. This is actually the hangar.
Here in the hangar, you'll be able to repair and upgrade your Autobot warriors and manage your supplies.
So here you start off with three bots. One is a healer, a triage.
For our noble cause. Now they are ready to fight for the Autobots once again. Command them responsibly and with pride.
And you have a scout named Overclock. He has more range type weapons. You want to stand back away from battle with him because he can get killed pretty easily. They give you some credits to start off. It just shows you how to buy a character.
So you have sufficient space and resources to command your growing battle group effectively. To assist you in managing your hangar, we are assigning you a new recruit.
See that guy talking? I'm pretty sure that's Prowl. We actually got a toy of him. He never really showed up in the show.
Further, Commander. If you are ready for deployment to the front lines, access the battle map.
Here you can go in and give yourself a custom paint job from the start. You can unlock more colors and shades and skins over time with the credits and relics that you earn in the game throughout. Here you can customize your special moves. Eventually you can unlock speed, armor, different shield upgrades. Now this game is all web browser based. You're gonna actually go out to the website and load it up. It's pretty impressive for a web browser game. I'm not sure what the specifications are. I know I was welcomed into the closed beta due to my high-end system. I have about 16 gigs of RAM, dedicated video graphics, about 4 gigs of that on a GeForce card. I'm playing at high quality, the highest it will go at the moment. I can get about 60 FPS frame rate. I'm recording at about 30 to 15 at the moment. It goes up and down depending on how much going on the screen. Like this swirling vortex of death he's about to be sucked into. That's actually a ground bridge where you enter the ground bridge, enter into a tournament, but it looks like both teams need at least 4 players, and it looks like I was the only one online at the time. So hopefully I'll come back. The closed beta is open for next day or so. They might have some players on. I might be able to try it again this evening. Otherwise, I'm not sure when the next open beta is going to be, but hopefully soon. Outside, this is the starting area. It's a small town, looks like it's out west of Oregon or Washington somewhere. It's pretty empty right now. The environment is somewhat destructible. Now you're out and about doing missions. The purpose of these missions is to quest and build up your character. You're going to obtain relics from completing your missions. Relics you can then build up and use to trade in for upgrades like weapons, paint jobs, and special moves. Also, get enough relics, well, you can unlock higher level characters and different robot designs or a different class altogether. The music in this game isn't that great, so I might put in my own soundtrack. Out there, not even the rabbits run over and swoosh. Receive an objective, and as you can see on the mini-map, where your objective is, the enemies show up the red, and the waypoints usually will show up the red where you go back. Actually for a medic class, I'm using the scout class, so I won't be able to complete it. So what I'll need to do is skip this video as I ran around doing nothing for the next 20 minutes trying to figure it out. Switch to a medic class. There's some Viacons up ahead. Those need to be taken out before you can heal the autobots, which somewhat look like Jazz. There. So I need to go switch to the medic class. Now here you'll see if your bot is damaged, you can go to a repair bay toward the center of the map. If you stand here, it'll actually start healing you right away, but if you want to heal yourself immediately, you gotta insert 50 energon, which you can collect from bad guys. Here I'm going to switch to the medic class. This portal takes you into your hangar where you can trees between your characters real quick. Turbo boost on here. Kind of forgot what I'm doing. I'm a terrible driver. There is a weapon assault mode, and there's the turbo boost shooting out his muffler. You can upgrade that over time to become even faster. Just drive right into that big ass rock. Now all the vehicons have suddenly disappeared. I'm not sure why, but that's one bad thing about driving is you can't jump as a car, which they should put that in there somehow. So you have your healing beam. Now your healing beam will overheat. It not only heals your comrades, but it also restores their force field, which is a bit of a challenge. If you're under attack yourself, it's going to overheat, and you'll need to pause in between healing to turn around and fight somebody else. This is just a basic mission. Once you heal these guys, they go back into a ground bridge and teleport out of there. Seems to take a long time to heal their force field, though. Come on, I don't have all day. Go back home. He just blipped out and he didn't even walk into it.
I hope you like smashing things up.
I just earned some relics for healing those guys. I'll go back into my next mission here. This is an assault cannon. These are really tough. It's looks like it's gonna kill my medic if I don't do something. It's time to go switch to a more brute class. Go get that monsoon character here. Have enough energy on, spend it all on burritos. Okay, I went back and got the warrior class and heading back to destroy that cannon. Warrior class does have better weapons. He has a long-range grenade launcher, which is probably the best to use against these cannons, as it can stay away from a distance and shoot grenades. If you need to take down an enemy shield, as these cannons have, you want to switch to an energon axe, which you hold and charge up, take a swipe, and it takes down the shield rather quickly. Although I'm getting shot up in the process, so it's probably best if you use the grenades. straight down its throat. So I'm pretty damaged here. I better get back and heal myself. I decided to stop in town and get some food first. They have the Dairy King. Not as good as Dairy Queen. And Mom's Great Big Meatballs, I guess they have signs for meatballs over town. Looks like no one's lived in this town since the 50s. It's all abandoned, although it's pretty good shape. Nobody looking out the windows screaming, "Oh my god, a giant robot!" Here I'm about to confront another Viacon. This one looks more like the TV show. Seeing he's just a scout class, but he is pretty strong. Surprised I haven't gotten killed yet. I suck at some of these games. It reminds me a lot of Warcraft. How you just have the one-on-one combat and free roam aspects to it. I think once this game's polished up a bit and has more graphics and more things walking around and definitely more players than just me, should be a lot more fun. I'm almost dead again. I'm on the next mission. The entire map is now filled with these enemy turrets, which are pounding my butt, so I need to get more firepower and come back later. Maybe I can go get a weapon upgrade, so I'm just going to go into a brief overview of the upgrade system. Alright, here we are back in the hangar where you can trade in your relics and points that you've earned defeating enemies. It shows all the awards that you've earned on your quest. I'm not sure if the awards can be traded in. I'm sure it ranks you up eventually. You can upgrade your weapons, buy new weapons. If you go into the store, you can spend points on different bombs, different energon upgrades, weapon upgrades, and increase your damage. You can spend your points and relics to purchase more characters, new paint jobs and skins. Looks like they'll be, over time, adding in more characters. It's a big money sink. You can actually spend a lot of cash and buy points, which I don't do. I like playing for free and earning my way up, although some characters are going to be limited to early founders of the game. If you want to invest $50, you get two more robots. If you want to invest $100, you get five total more. Some are pretty cool, and you can only get by spending real money on the game. I don't know who would want to spend $200 for a online robot, but if you want to be more advanced than anybody else, that's one way to do it. Some of these characters weren't loading for me. They may not be finished yet, but the game should be open to a public beta soon at some point. There's Showdown. He's like a more of a warrior class. He has a giant hammer he can smash Decepticons with. Now, like I said, I chose the Autobot side when I signed up for the beta, so I'm guessing if you signed up for Decepticon, this entire system has a different set of options for you. One final look at the three robots you start off with, or the Autobot team: Overclock, Monsoon, and Triage. Thanks for watching my very first Let's Play video. I plan to do more in the future. I also plan to do more toy reviews and just some other general videos. I'm right now in the process of moving to a new apartment. But I'll keep in touch and check back soon. Thanks for watching, and subscribe and share if you haven't already. Have a good week.